Hey guys, it's Adeline. Nice to meet ya. Welcome to the weird side of YouTube.
I'm not as normal as you thought I would be, am I?
You guys have been liking my makeup tutorials a lot recently, so I wanted to do kind of like a really easy everyday makeup tutorial that shows a good foundation routine that you guys can use. And also make sure to subscribe. Me in the morning. This tutorial will make you so fierce. You'll be like your momager in your face, like boom, like, you know. Don't mess with me and my $10 foundation. Makeup just has that effect. You guys know that I always put primer on before my foundation or BB cream or anything that I use just because I want my makeup to stay all day long. So I'm gonna be using my CoverGirl LS All Day Primer. This is great because it's from the drugstore. A lot of the products that I'm using are CoverGirl just because I really love their foundations and their face products.
I partnered up with CoverGirl in this video, yes. These products are actually awesome and not opinions on my own.
So I'm putting that on with my fingers because, you know, in the morning when I'm putting on makeup, I'm probably in a hurry because I'm always late for everything. Okay, so two of my favorite face products that I've been using are the CoverGirl. This is the Clean Matte Foundation and this is the Clean Matte BB Cream. Usually I would use this if I'm like on my period and I'm like breaking out a lot. Very pimply, very bad. It covers up a lot. It helps controls oily skin, but it also it like doesn't dry out your skin at all either. It doesn't feel really heavy or cakey at all. It's like super weird. It has like oil absorbing powders, but also conditioners for your skin. So it prevents oil, but it also doesn't dry out your skin.
Cool.
I have a bunch of their old like foundations and stuff like that. Like I literally have like, and like I've noticed that they have more yellow toned foundations, which are really good for like darker skin tones. So yeah, praise the foundation. On most days I would just go for the Clean Matte BB Cream, and I really like this because it's like very light, you don't feel on skin. So I'm just gonna put this on the back of my hand and then dab it on my face.
Ooh,
dab. You know what's really like? No, can't believe I just did that in a video. Oil-free BB cream. And apparently it has three different powders in the BB cream and they fight against shine. Like this is, it's like a little superhero. I'm a little BB cream hero. It has a very flexible film and it's like comfortable on your skin. It has both its powders and its pigment system and it just like combines to make the perfect BB cream and it like covers up pimples and it diffuses light and it's just like, that's why I'm using it. It's so amazing. Did my research. And like one tip that I've learned, you don't have to wear foundation and BB cream just because you don't like your skin. Like the main reason why I wear foundation and BB cream and all that stuff is because it really does make my bronzer, my highlighter stay on a lot better. Put on as much makeup as you want, girl. Well, I was home alone like 5 minutes ago. Now there's someone walking downstairs. You know this video. You know this video. Oh. It's either my mom or a murderer. Mommy? Oh, I thought you were a murderer. Less is more. So I always put like very little on my hand just so that I don't use it too much. Because whenever I like put too much on my hand, I always use it all and then I end up looking cakey. So I always put very little, like pea size. Focus on that. Stop focusing on my face. Pea size and I'm out. Little pea. All right, and then for that very nice glow, I'm going to be taking this CoverGirl Ready Set Gorgeous Concealer. Why does it not focus? But it's like the lightest shade that they have, I think. But I'm just going to be highlighting with this concealer. So I'm going to be putting that like underneath my eyes, and the bridge of my nose, underneath my eyebrows, and my forehead, Cupid's bow, underneath like my chin. You know the drill. This is how I steal your man, like this. And I'm just gonna be blending that with my fingers. You can also use a damp sponge if you want. I think doing this makes you look a lot younger and more glowy. And now for this concealer, I love my life. I like liquid concealers for under eye and I like hot concealers for pimples. Covers up dark circles and it blends really easily. Shine free and it doesn't clog your pores. Thank the Lord. And then to set all of my foundation and stuff like that, you can also bake. Oh my gosh. I'm not gonna do that. For powder, just to like kind of set everything, I'm gonna be using the CoverGirl Clean Matte powder. So I use little brush. Now this powder is supposed to be put on with this foundation. Like they're like a little couple. Relationship goals. Like I like being a rebel. I'm using the BB cream. It has like oil absorbers in it, so it makes your pores less visible, but it doesn't clog your pores. I don't know how. The oil absorbing powders control oily shine. Yeah, that's how I get very like Photoshop looking skin, and it's all CoverGirl products. It's like from the drugstore. It's so cheap. And how I look tan. I know I was in Australia and New Zealand for like 2 months, but in Canada it's still cold and I got paler, so you guys can't fight me on this. If you guys want to see my vlogs for Australia and New Zealand, the vlog channel will be linked down below. Now for the highlights, that glow. I'm using an illuminator. I like this one because it has little gold sparkles in it. Why do, when meteors show it, they always go like this? I never understood why. Is it because you can't like see your camera? Do you see yourself? Yeah, I'm gonna be using this illuminator and I'm just gonna be putting that on the high points of my cheekbones. And I like to use kind of like a really dense fan brush. And I'm applying it to the high points of my cheekbones, so it's kind of like bling, you know what I mean? I'm also gonna be putting it on my cupid's bow, my chin, and very, very, very little on my forehead. Not a lot. Yeah, when I put too much highlighter on my forehead, I always feel like that horse from Twitter where it's like, ooh girl, where'd you get that highlighter from? I haven't had my eyebrows done in so long. I look like, I'm just so traumatized from like people doing my eyebrows really thin. Oh yes, I keep her eyebrow thick. But I haven't gotten my eyebrows done in I think 3 months. But I just fixed some makeup. I look decent eyebrows with makeup. I'm using this bronzer. Tip of the day. I think that eyeshadows work perfectly for highlight. Like a light shimmery eyeshadow, and matte browns work perfectly for contour. So if you guys are ever like stuck and you want to like try something new, then maybe try your eyeshadows as contour and highlight. I think it's so fun. And blush. I'm gonna be taking that and I'm basically just gonna go underneath the highlight. I'm also bringing it up towards my temples and covering up them double chins. Oh my gosh, I saw this vine and this girl, she basically like, she ruined her double chins. Here, I'm gonna do it. This eyeliner, it has like a clear top and a clear bottom and I just lost it. Like it's clear, like I can't find it on my floor. Are you guys ready for this? I got broads in Atlanta. And that's how you get the ladies. Guys, boys. I'm literally gonna leave this on for the entire tutorial. Hello! Can't find anything. I keep burping and I didn't even eat. I literally think that I'm burping because I'm so hungry. Alright, now I'm gonna be taking this peachy tone blush. I really like this because it goes really good with more tan skin tones. And I'm gonna be putting this on the apples of my cheeks. And I'm also gonna be putting a little teeny tiny bit on my chin and like teensy meensy like little teeny tiny pieces on like so that it just evens out. Ooh girl, but look at that glow!
I'm obsessed with eyeliner.
And for the brows, I always tell you guys you can totally use like a brown eyeliner and it's so much cheaper, but I'm just gonna be using this and I'm using a brush with a little spoolie. And basically what I like to do with my eyebrows is, should I go up closer? No. Yes. Yes. Basically what I like to do with my eyebrows is make a line underneath my eyebrows. I like to go a little bit lower than my actual eyebrow just because I like to make my eyebrows look a little bit thicker and a little teeny tiny line above. I like to make the highest part of my eyebrow on the top a little bit more to the center than on my bottom, if that makes any sense. I also like to make my eyebrows look very kind of like ombre, so I apply more product over here and less product over here. Like, ah! I screamed a little bit. Now on to eyes. I have time. I'm gonna be using kind of like a shimmery inner corner highlight color. It's just kind of like a very nice champagne color. Again, you guys can totally use this as a highlighter. I'm being so serious about that. If you guys do use it as a highlighter or you recreate this makeup look, tweet me because I want to see. Tag me on Instagram or something. Just be internet best friend. I'm gonna try to like and like retweet and favorite as many as I can. And now I'm gonna be taking this kind of like light brownie kind of shade. I'm mainly putting it on my crease and then a little bit on the outer part of my lip. And then with the same like brush and eyeshadow, I'm just gonna be putting that underneath my eyes. Cool girl, my subscribers are really showing. And now I'm going to be curling my eyelashes and curling them so that my eyelashes are higher than Drake's album on the iTunes chart. And I like to use like multiple mascaras, so I'm gonna use one coat of one and one coat of the other. So at first I brush up my eyelashes and then I go behind my eyelashes like that, and I find that makes them super super long. And then I kind of let that coat dry and then apply the other mascara. There you go, mascara on my eyelid. I know that you can prevent it with like a little business card, but honestly, does anybody really have time for that? Like, I'm just gonna fix it with my finger. And I'm gonna be doing one coat on my bottom eyelashes as well. I find that bottom mascara really like opens up your eyes. Alright, and now on to lips. For me personally, I love wearing very mauve-y lip colors. I think it's kind of like my signature style, or what do you call it? My signature style is also double chin, so like don't even listen to me. So I've been using the same lip combo for like so long, and usually when I just do my makeup, I just use the same thing. And what I'm gonna be doing is, I'm gonna be overlining my lips. Ooh. It tasted like a brownie. I just had a brownie. With the natural line of your lip, I usually just follow that throughout my entire lip. And the only parts that I really overline is in the middle of my lip. So I'd overline like my cupid's bow and like right here. I don't know why I always, ooh, I kind of look like Kim Possible. Yeah. Also apologize for my mustache because as I haven't done my eyebrows in 2 months, I also haven't done that in 3 months. Mine and Matt's mustache are almost the same. And I'm gonna be going over that with a little lip gloss. Hello? Hey! I know I overline my lips. I really like using matte lip color because the shine in lip color, and when I don't use a matte lip color, it just makes the overlining, like the part of my lip and the part that's my skin. It makes the line very visible with the shine and the lighting. I like how I just, this is one of my go-to makeup looks that I've just been going to. I really like this makeup because it doesn't have eyeliner, so it's very fast and very, very glowy, which I enjoy. Shine bright like a diamond. Might be too much for people, might be too little for people who are very like, ooh girl, so glam. I think my favorite part of the makeup look is this. It makes it so unique. Yeah, I change up my everyday makeup look like so often. Like I probably change it like at least like once or twice a week. If you guys want another very neutral look, or if you guys want another celebrity transformation look, any videos that you guys want, comment that down below because I want to do what you guys want me to do. Also make sure to check out my vlog channel because my vlog channel is just weird. It's a good way to waste time, 5 minutes of your life that you're never gonna get back, you know? Baby, come back. And I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, then make sure to give it a thumbs up and also make sure to subscribe and become Adelangel emoji. Yeah, Adelangels are the best. We're so positive, so nice, best fandom ever. I love you guys. Make sure to check out my tourism videos down below, and also check out my social media like Instagram, Twitter, Snapchat, all that stuff. My username is Adeline Warren on basically every single social media, and I'm not verified because I'm a potato, so don't look for a verification. Jif Palm is verified! I mean, like, he's living. I'm just a potato. Potatoes aren't living, so I guess that's why I'm not verified. Or just I'm irrelevant. But I hope that you guys have a beautiful, magical, wonderful day. You're way more amazing than you could ever imagine, and you're way more loved than you could ever, ever, ever imagine. I love you guys so, so, so much, and I'll hopefully see you guys in my next video. Bye. Get the best of both worlds. Chewing milk, take it natural. Then you end up with big lashes. Looking for a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting out of bed and chicken and me get up. It's all an illusion. Adeline, are you talking about me? Because honestly, if you are, then whatever. Sorry about her. She just got back. She's not so fond of my makeup tutorials. I don't even know if we're actually sisters. Comment down below for a sister/twin tag, or I'm killing her in her sleep. My room is right there. Do you want your precious Adeline?